The wisdom in I Ching feng shui is the foundation of world peace. Good day to audience around the world. Welcome to professional I Ching feng shui TV station, Weixin TV station. Today is Monday, October 8th, 2018, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona Zhang Xinfang. For this week's Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan's footprint, we're showing you the first meeting of the 5th Board of Directors and members of Taiwan Guigu Cultural Academy.
The first meeting of the 5th Board of Supervisors and members of the Taiwan Guigu Cultural Academy was held in the Zaozhen Buddha Zhenghao on September 29th. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan's attended the meeting. The meeting was chaired by President Yang Jidong. In the agenda, the supervisors and members were re-elected and the general meeting was held. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed the virtuous fellows.
Guigu Kultura Academy 已经改了一届了。原来鬼谷学士研究会，学士研究是开始，那是在升华。现在，奉王禅老祖开示。啊，改为鬼谷文化学会，啊，这个就是代表着王禅老祖所交给我们的天命，啊，鬼谷子的智慧已经全部升华，所以我们今后呢，要让这个学会。啊，作为中华民族三祖儿女的啊道心，心连心，手牵手，共创世界真和平的明灯，啊，由这里开始。啊，所以今天啊，我们。我预计还是请杨会长啊和所有的李监事们已经被选上的李监事李监事们啊大家啊与所有的贤士同修啊我们遵照王禅老祖的圣事啊务必把我们这一生要做出啊问心无愧而有成就的一生。
President Yang Jidong also encouraged members.
期望越高，我们的愿力也就要越大。那我们希望大家共同努力，共同来达成整个世界和平、天下太平的这个大愿望。
The General Secretary General then carried out the work report and the conference report, and the conference ended successfully. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi also encouraged virtuous fellows to turn the Dharma wheel to present the wondrous Dharma in the world. Wishing news at Shenfeng Temple.
After Hualien Branch Temple's completion and its solemn completion ceremony, we're focusing on another important construction of Weixin Shenjiao in 2018. The construction of Xinzhu Dafan Branch Temple is also completed. On October 27th, the birthday of Guanyin Bodhisattva, the temple is hosting two ceremonies. Seat completion ceremony of Wangchan Laozu, the completion and unveiling ceremony of Dafan Branch Temple. Let's take a look at the footage for further information.
The construction of Dafan Branch Temple is going to be completed. The Sanyuan Jingran Hall and the Holy Man Hall completion ceremony are scheduled to be held on October 27th. The Dafan Branch Temple Abbot, Master Yuan Tong, invites the fellows and virtuous friends from 10 directions to attend the grand ceremony to pray for the world peace. Dafan Branch Temple is one of the first established branch temples in Weixin Shenjiao. However, the building of the main hall has been delayed for many years. It was not until 2016 that the construction of the temple began to be completed, and the wish of the abbot, Master Yuan Tong, was completed. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi instructed the story of Jiu Tian Sheng Di to show that admirable of mutual inclusive virtue. Da Fan Branch Temple Abbot Master Yuan Tong is a senior master of Weixin Sheng Jiao and is also the initiator who persuaded Grandmaster to propagate the teachings. Weixin Sheng Jiao started the class with this reason and spread the Dharma of Yi Jing. Da Fan Branch Temple was unveiled on the 27th and started a 5-day medicine Buddha ritual at 7 to 9 a.m. and set up various lotus seeds to liberate and purify the soul of our ancestor and spirit. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi will preside revealing ceremony. Welcome everyone to participate in the ceremony of Da Fan Branch Temple at Xinzhu Weixin Sheng Jiao and pray for the world peace together. Weixin News, Da Fan Branch Temple.
Take a break, we will come back soon.
不虚千秋，吉祥。
Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi instructs us that different religions are endowed with different providence when they reveal in the world. Society is benefited by different religions' expertise. In this week's Weixin Sheng Jiao feature story, we are showing you the relationship between Yi Jing Feng Shui and the worldly affairs. We hope that by telling real stories happened around us, you will be able to understand the wisdom behind the application of Yi Jing Feng Shui and the Yi divination. Ladies and gentlemen, 阿弥陀佛. Welcome for watching Weixin Sheng Jiao feature story. Today we are going to share the Feng Shui principles about Feng Shui and medicine part 1 from Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi. The government kept losing money after the set of national health insurance. Some people think that Taiwanese love to wreck medicine. The medicine is either taken for sickness or strengthen their health. Therefore, people will find some excuse to get the medicine from hospital. That's why the medicine resources become a waste. National Health Insurance Administration, of course, is losing money. It is true that some people think that they still need to take some medicine although they are not ill. Otherwise, for them, it becomes a waste to pay the insurance fee. However, for those who are really sick, this statement is not fair to them. If we are feeling well, we are normally reluctant to queue up for doctor to get injection or have surgery. What we truly need to discuss is why there are so many people suffering from sickness. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi has long been practicing Tao and met uncountable fellows. According to his experience, sickness is always related to Feng Shui. You may not have peace by preaching the rules of Feng Shui in home, factory, and office. There was a doctor who used to be healthy. However, his right leg became disabled uncomfortably after setting up his own clinic, and it got worsened. He spent a lot in diagnosis, but the leg still could not get healed. One day, he went to Chanji Shanxianfo Temple to worship Buddha with his wife. He mentioned his problem to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi asked him about the clinic environment and concluded the problem is a lacration, suggesting him to adjust the door orientation in order to improve his leg condition. However, the doctor thought that it is kind of superstition. His wife came to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi again and asked for help. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi then visited the clinic in person. He found that the alley is exceptionally long from the door. It crashed seriously. He then persuaded the doctor to change the orientation of the door to solve the leg problem. Otherwise, his right leg could never be helped. The doctor still showed no response, but his wife then hired some people to proceed the change according to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi. After 3 to 4 months, Doctor's leg was recovered. He called to Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi to say thank you and apologize. He admitted that he knew nothing about feng shui and should not criticize it in advance. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi pointed out that if we do not follow the rules of feng shui, our health will be affected silently. Many patients cannot find out their own cause of illness, which are probably caused by feng shui. If government can adore feng shui and promote it, the number of patients will certainly be decreased. The expenditure of National Health Insurance Administration will be lowered too. How grateful the Mary is! Thank you for watching Wei Xin Shenjiao Feature Story. We will share more stories about feng shui and medicine in the coming episodes. Wei Xin Shenjiao Mary Foundation plays a significant role in the development of Wei Xin Shenjiao. Each branch and its branch presidents is endowed with the providence of forming good affinities with others, preaching the principles of living a wise life and fulfilling Wei Xin Shenjiao's 48 great vows for the realization of world peace. Wei Xin Shenjiao offers social services for the neighborhood and mass dedication to the people so as to live in the spirit of altruism. On September 30th, in headquarters Shanjishan Xianfo Temple, we hosted commendation ceremony of prestigious branch presidents. It was a venue of encouragement and acknowledgement of the dedication and offerings the virtuous fellows have devoted to.
On September 30th, Wei Xin Shenjiao Marriage Foundation held a commendation ceremony for the branch presidents of outstanding performance and an oath-taking ceremony for the new ones, representing Wangchang Laozhu, Buddha's Bodhisattva sages and deities. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chan Shi recognized and praised the remarkable performance of the branch presidents. As estimated, 2,000 branch presidents received commendation. With 500 of them attending the ceremony at Wei Xin Shenjiao's headquarters, we thank them for their devotion to Wei Xin Shenjiao and the spirit of Yijing Feng Shui, enabling people to lead a smooth life and our society to be secure. Grandmaster instructed.
那么我们今天的表扬是在应《金刚经》佛所说的。我们世间上的一切有为法，如梦幻泡影，如露亦如电，应作如是观。世间上的有为法，梦幻泡影，千真万确的，唯有智者，依佛所开示。老祖所开示给我们的行功立德、修行的好机会、平台，让我们修行。平时我们要来世间上度有缘的人，我们过去生多生有缘的亲人和我们的朋友。善友和恩人，在这一生都已经来到世间上投胎转世，各行各业各种的事业各随因缘，在社会上，在人世间，在修行。修行不是只有说去佛寺的修行，修行有八正道的修行，正业、正确的工作。所以当下现21世纪的现在，我们的修行就是八正道的正业、正确的工作，正确的事业和职业，这是我们成佛的一条捷径。
Later, Grand Master awarded the branch president certificates in honor of the remarkable performance. Then, Master Yuan Dao, the Secretary General of Weijing Shenzhen Marriage Foundation, led 53 new branch presidents to attend the oath-taking ceremony. Grand Master instructed that, in addition to 42 branch temples of Weijing Shenzhen, each branch president could stand for a miniature one as well. Thus, Grand Master expected them to regard their family as a branch temple, and vice versa. In the long run, we can roll the Dharma wheel of world peace. Weixin News, Headquarters, Changjishan Xianfu Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
Weixin Shengjiao Yue Li Dao.
For this week's Yijing Feng Shui Education, Jilong Branch Temple's abbot, Master Yuan Tang, took his fellow students to the Lover's Lake for a field trip on September 30th. Take a look.
Master Yuan Tang of Weixin Shenzhen Jilong Branch Temple led the virtuous fellows having outdoor teaching on September 30th for interpreting mountains in Feng Shui. Master Yuan Tang and virtuous fellows arrived at Jilong Lover's Lake to investigate its Feng Shui. He explained, according to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's instructions, there are three main points while investigating the geography in Feng Shui. First, observe the strike direction of rock. Second, notice the direction of plant growth. Third, experience the wind flow. In Feng Shui speak, it means qi. Master also told students that this natural feature of a landscape was a good feng shui example and showed all main points which Grandmaster instructed before, like a treasure feng shui node is often found at the tail of the mountain range. Observe the orientation of mountain range round. Dragon turn round to defend the host in feng shui speak. Furthermore, Master Yuan Tang spoke of Grandmaster's instructions at Jilong Branch Temple's completion ceremony. Jilong's name derives from a Hong Feng, which means chicken coop. There had rooster, hen, and chicks. Hens care for chicks at home, while rooster work out to support its family. Weixin Virtuous Fellows were very grateful to Master Yuan Tang for his unselfishly sharing about Feng Shui inspection. On the field trip, they also meet believers who immediately recognized Master Yuan Tang because this couple loves to watch the programs of Weixin TV station, and they were very happy to meet here unexpected. Besides, hikers also appreciated Wang Chan Lao Zu and felt our Dharma was really very great. Everyone was full of joy and the field trip was conducted successfully. Weixin News, Jilong Branch Temple.
Last, we are sharing with you this week's Branch Temple's events. Weixin Shenzhen Kaohsiung Branch Temple held the Disaster Elimination and Benediction Ritual for its 16th anniversary on September 29th. Disaster Elimination and Benediction Rituals are open to the general public. We welcome everyone to join us for recitation of the scripture and pray for the harmony of the mind and soul. Rituals of Weixin Shenzhen take care of everyone's ancestors and the karma creditors and friends in your past lives by offering them abundant joy and spiritual enlightenment from the scriptures.
On September 29 and 30, Weixin Shenzhen Kaohsiung Branch Temple held the 16th anniversary disaster elimination and benediction ritual. The abbot, Master Yuan Pu, hosted the ceremony and invited Master Yuan Meng and the chanters from Weixin Shenzhen Chanting College to officiate the ritual. All Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and deities were piously invited to radiantly descend to the altar to receive the offerings and appreciation from the virtuous fellows and followers. They sincerely prayed to Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and deities to turn the Dharma wheel together, to propagate the Dharma, and to benefit all human beings. Several lotus tablets were set up on the mandala, including 15,615 surnames of Chinese ancestors, 917 Chinese emperors and their family spirits, the race of 3,762 wars in China, wandering spirits in the local district, the spirits of ancestors of the virtuous fellows in Kaohsiung Branch Temple, and so on. Furthermore, this year, following the instruction of Wang Chan Lao Zhu, the tablets of prosperity and longevity for the president, the vice president, and all the people of Republic of China were also set up on the mandala. In the afternoon of the 29th, the ceremony began after purification and spirit summoning rite. With the holy Buddhist chants and the solemn rite, may all the spirits come to listen to the scripture, learn the Dharma, and attain the enlightenment in order to reborn in the Western Buddhist Pure Land. We also pray to Buddhas to bless the family and career life of all Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Virtuous Fellows and the harmony of the society. The local Virtuous Fellows of Kaohsiung Bridge Temple all volunteer to help the decoration of the ceremony. The cooking volunteers not only help to cook meals for every participant, but also busy for making the delicacies for the altar's offering. In the afternoon of the 30th, Master Yuan Meng used the power of Bodhisattva to make an offering of sweet dew to all spirits in three rings without being hungry. We sincerely pray for the prosperity and safety of the nation and the local district. Through the blessings of Wang Chan Lao Zhu, we wish all the administrative affairs of Kaohsiung Branch Temple, leading by Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi, would work smoothly and successfully. Weixin News, Kaohsiung Branch Temple.
Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi reveals the profound wisdom of Yi Jing Feng Shui in simple language. He integrates the art of divination, unveils the mysteries of Yi Jing Feng Shui in the hearts of the public, and creates a wonderful life for you and me with the righteous religion. Thank you for joining us today. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday, and 11:30 in the morning and 4 o'clock in the afternoon on every Tuesday for every week's Weixin News on Weixin TV. Wang Chan Lao Zhu bless you and your family. World peace. See you next week.